In this video, I'm going to add some layers of oil paint over the gloss coat of Future that I finished with in part 1. I'm going to add the paint neat straight from the tube without diluting it, and I'll be using my favourite weathering colour, Buff, to build up some rain marks as the first layer. Using a brush moistened with white spirit, I'll now work the paint across the gloss surface, using vertical strokes to achieve the effects of streaked dust. When you start doing this, you'll notice that the oil really is moving around on top of the gloss coat, so you've got complete control over the effect. I like to use a broad, flat brush towards the end, just to soften the whole effect. In reference pictures of this vehicle, the top edge of the crew compartment is usually kept clean by the crew's hands, so I will wipe the paint away in this area with a brush moistened with white spirit. Once this layer is dry, I'm going to seal it all in with Vallejo matte acrylic varnish and clear mixed with tap water. This will create a barrier between the oil coats, allowing me to add more oils without the two layers mixing. Whenever you see a layer title like this, it means I've added a layer of varnish. I'm sure you don't want to watch me add the varnish every time. Now I will work back into the dusty layer with a dark brown wash to produce some more dirty streaks. Again, I work in vertical strokes, and on this occasion I'll work from raised points like the screw heads. For the third layer, I'm going to switch back to using the Buff colour. This time I will mix the wash a little richer, and I will start mapping in a random fashion. In the middle of the panels, I will allow the dust effect to build up a little heavier than before. Then I gently just blend that back in with a few vertical streaks, and as you can see, it's built up a much heavier dust effect. Now the oil layers are complete, it may look a little odd at the moment, so I'm going to blend this all together using some Vallejo Air Light Brown to give me a feathered dust effect around the running gear and the lower area of the model. I airbrush a light coat with a nice smooth gradient all along the lower edge and the top of the running gear. As you can see, this has really tied the two effects together well, and the weathering seems to flow from the top of the vehicle down to the running gear.